Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. May peace and blessings of Allah be upon Muhammad and the family of the Holy Prophet Muhammad. When we look at the history, we come to know that the Holy Prophet wanted us, the people who live at this time, to have the connection with the Imam of our time since the Holy Prophet was alive and before he departed from this world. Take, for example, the event of Ghadeer. When the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam was giving his final farewell Hajj, and when he was talking to people at the Ghadeer in this area, Ghadeer Khum, when he was coming from the last pilgrimage, in one of the sermon he said that Allah wa inni nabiyun wa aliyun wa suyi. People know that I am your Nabi and Ali is my wasi. It means that the executor who will take charge after me in terms of returning the trusts, in terms of taking care of the religion, in terms of protecting the religion, in terms of answering the questions, and so on and so forth. Until when the Holy Prophet said, Allah wa anna khatam al-a'imma minna al-qa'im. All people know that the one who is the last imam is from us, and he will come to take charge of this religion. Now look, my dear brothers and sisters, at this hadith that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, Nabiyur Rahmah, the messenger of mercy, is telling us that at the end, the last imam who will come to take charge of the affairs of Muslims, he will be the imam from the family of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. Now, one thing which is very important, at Hijjatul Wada, and especially at the Ghadeer Khum, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, when he was talking to his companions, he says, فَلْيُبَلِّغُ الشَّاهِدُ مِنْكُمُ الْغَائِبُ. Let the one who is present here today convey this message to those who are not here. So as we see the hadith, it is as if the Holy Prophet wanted to say, those companions who are there, they should convey the message to those who came after, meaning at-tabi'in, and those who came after, tabi'i tabi'in. And not only that, from one family, a father should inform the child about what the Holy Prophet has said. And this child, when he grows up, he informs his children about what the Holy Prophet has said. Up to our time now, we are informing one another about the role and the position of Imam Al-Mahdi alayhi salam. This shows that Rasulullah cared for this ummah, and he left nothing without informing us what will happen. It is our duty also to make sure the role of Imam and roles of the noble people, our children come to know. They need to come to know the Imam of our time, that he will show mercy not only to them but to the whole mankind. And it is here we need to remember that Imam alayhi salam needs our prayers the way he prays for us. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.